Welcome to Rails Around York. The trains were pulled by giant steam locomotives with all the sounds of a living machine. Diesels replaced the steam locomotive, and some of the romance with the rails was lost. Come along as we see the railroads of today and the past on Rails Around York. The Red Line Train Station Model Railroad has an open house for the public to view the historic rail station and model train layouts on selected dates. These are usually in April and October each year to coincide with the meetings of the Train Collectors Association at the Expo Center in York. There is also an open house in August when Red Line holds their old-fashioned days. Then on selected dates in December, the station is open in conjunction with the Red Line Historical Society through New Year's Eve. The train station and layout can also be seen by organizations throughout the year by appointment. This can be arranged by calling Skip Stewart at 757-3972. Thank you.
chose to follow others around the crossing gate.
I am.
This is the next 60 seconds of your life.
Let's go. Come on, let's go. There's no train. Let's go.
I'm going.
No.
America's roads can be highways or dieways. The choice is yours.
comes directly under, you gotta move off to the side, because sometimes hot cinders can blow out from the stack. Thank you.
Howdy, folks. I'm Pastor Kevin Trout from Bible Baptist Church on the Susquehanna Trail in York, Pennsylvania. And, you know, your program about trains is a blessing. And trains have been a very important part of American history, especially early American history. And as we think about trains and trains running on the right track and staying on the right track, it reminds me of the verse in John chapter 14 and verse 6, where Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." And, you know, when it comes to salvation, we need to make sure, just like those trains have to stay on that track, we need to make sure that we're on the right track as far as getting to heaven and having our sins forgiven. And the wonderful thing about that is Jesus Christ is that way to heaven. He said it in John chapter 14 and verse 6. The greatest verse in the Bible, I'm sure that you have heard this verse before, is John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in Him has everlasting life." And with that verse, we find out that Jesus is that way to get to heaven. And there's four things a person has to realize in order to know 100% sure that they're going to heaven. And the first thing we need to realize is that we have all sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible says there is none righteous, no, not one, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And once I realize that, once I realize that I am a sinner and I have come short of God's glory, and the second thing I need to realize is that there is a penalty for that sin, and that's separation from God forever in a place called hell. And the Bible says the wages of sin is death. And that death is the second death. And that's a spiritual death. And we have to realize that we owe a sin debt as sinners, and we can't pay it. And the third thing a person needs to realize is that Jesus, 2,000 years ago, God's only begotten Son, came to earth and died on a Roman cross. And they put nails in His hands and feet, and they put a crown of thorns on His head. And Jesus hung on that cross and shed His precious blood to wash our sins away. And I need to realize that if I'm going to be able to go to heaven. 1 John 5:13 says, "These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God." And so God wants you to know you have eternal life. And part of that is receiving Christ as your Savior, realizing that we have all sinned, realizing that we have a penalty for our sin, realizing that Jesus paid the penalty for us, thank God for that, and realizing that I personally have to trust Christ as my Savior and invite Him into my heart and life. The Bible says in Romans 10:13 that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And you can put your name in there. Whosoever shall call, put your name in there. Call, a desperate cry for help, upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. And I hope you'll do that today. I hope you'll think about that. It's very important. As you've watched the show on trains and how that train is on the right track, you and I need to be on the right track as far as salvation is concerned, and Jesus is the only way to get there. Well, God bless you. He loves you. Thanks for tuning in.
I've been doing TV spots for Operation Lifesaver since 1985, but my railroad roots go back to my grandfather, my great-grandfather, and my own work experience on the railroad. I know how important it is to get people to look and listen when they come to a railroad crossing. It can take a mile or more for an engine like this to stop. So it's all up to you. Use your head and your brake. You never win an argument with a train.
Take the battery all the way
out. Please.
Oh, shit, sorry.
Railroad yards are not playgrounds. I know. I worked summers for the railroad. My grandfather and great-grandfather were railroad men. We've seen people hurt and people killed, young people, because they didn't listen to this advice. Stay off the tracks and out of railroad yards. Playing around trains is playing with your life.
Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Thank you for watching Rails Around York. We welcome your phone calls and comments. Call WRCT at 843-7722. We hope you enjoyed this program.
Good night.
Rails Around York is a Good Day production.